Oh, by God. We're not gonna just leave her there. She'll be eaten by rats.
Are you willing to risk your life just to go bury her?
Absolutely not. But still, what a sorry sight.
The Comtesse de Corvée. There is nothing more that can be done. This woman was not the victim of an automat, but of a murderer made of flesh and blood. I must immediately inform Monsieur de Mirabeau.
And I can still hear her cries. It was blood-curdling.
Who could be so cowardly as to attack a half-crazed woman?
Oh, I'd wager that it was the stranger I saw hanging around here for 2 days.
Oh yeah, I remember. A sort of strong man with a pockmarked face, wasn't he? A frightening face, really.
He was asking about the Countess. And he was insistent, the brute. But I knew how to hold my tongue. You know me.
The cutthroat must have succeeded in the end. God knows how he tricked the Countess into letting him in.
That's true. Our Countess was a highly suspicious woman. But why did he want to arm her?
No doubt it was because of those old rumours. As crazy and poor as she was, it seems that she kept a small treasure hidden under her bed. All that remained of her aristocratic life, it seems.
Mes compagnons, my dear friends, I don't deserve to outlive them.
Therefore, monsieur.
No! Get back! Assassin!
I'm not your enemy. My only aim is to defeat the royal army.
Why should I believe you? It's true that you can speak. Maybe you're truly not one of them.
What is this chaos? What disaster has befallen the Place Royale?
That's where we, loyal patriots, had gathered. A band of brave souls armed with what paltry weapons we could find. A few old sabers, some rusty muskets. That's all we needed to stop the enemy's advance. Hélas, the tyrant riposted from the heights of the Bastille. His cannons tore us to shreds. I could only flee while my comrades fell as heroes for our nation. What's the point of surviving if you must bend the knee to a bloodthirsty despot?
Monsieur.
Leave me now. I'll soon join my comrades. I already have one foot in the grave.